good evening. Welcome on this horrible cold. I don't know if it's cold and wet where you are, but it's very wet and quite cold where we are. Oh, let me just check my laptop is switched off. Don't want to get any feedback. But we're here, excited for our 11th Paper Crafts and Piano. Craig's ready on the piano there. It's been practicing this afternoon. Very nice tunes for tonight. So I shall turn the camera around. You can see the look at the rain and the decking out there. And I'll get set up. And then we'll get Craig playing a few lovely pieces of music for us. Ah, there it's focusing now. Let me just sort my camera out and see who we've got on. Hi Geraldine, hi Sally, hi Jill, hi Angela, welcome, welcome. So are you there, love?
Yeah,
is ready. So hi Jill, so if you can do the thumbs up, that would be amazing. So tonight, last week, I sort of indicated with the picture that I was going to do the peonies, and I didn't, because I needed to something easy. So tonight I am going to attempt the peonies, and I'm going to attempt to piece the peonies together. So I've picked out a few colours, but what I'm not going to do, I'm not going to do the peonies with the colours that come in the suite. I'm going to do some different colours, if that makes sense. I am going to use some of the papers, but I'm going to opt for grey ones, not the... Oh, they're all... Oh, all those ones are grey. So we'll have a little bit of that. Yep. So we'll use the grey ones tonight. Going to be a bit neutral. This is going to be my colour combo. So what I tend to do is choose a colour combo. So I'm using Highland Heather. And I'm going to use a bit of Smoky Slate, Pool Party, and Old Olive, and White. Okay, so I'm going to go for that. I might use Grey Granite, actually, but I've tried to plan ahead. Got my Pool Party ribbon out there. And I'll probably use some of this silvery Grey Granite ribbon as well. Okay. So, oh, we're all on. So, hi, Sally. I think I've said hi. Hi, Marlene. Hi, Lorraine. Hi, Maria. Hi, Lisa. Hope you had a nice birthday, Lisa. Lisa got some lovely Stampin' Up stuff from her husband. He arranged a secret shop with me to get some nice stuff. Right, I've decided what I'm going to do first. I'm going to do a card like we did on Coffee and Card. And I am going to the masking one, if you remember that one. Do you know what? I've not even got the peony stamp set out. I've got everything else out. I just realised I've not got the peony stamp set out. I can see it though from where I'm sat. Okay. I've not got my blocks out, but I've got my scissors and my glue out, Fiona. So I'm going to use that big stamp. So how are we all? Hi Rhonda. I'm not sure I'm recognising your name, Rhonda. Where are you from? Please, if you don't mind me asking. Hi Tracy. Have you made your shopping list yet? So welcome Tracy, we do this every Thursday. Hi Anne-Marie, hi Kathy. Wow, hi Rebecca. We've got lots on tonight, 20 of you. So if you can do a thumbs up on the video, You might have to close the chat down to do it. I'd be really grateful. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to do some masking. And I'm going to use this stamp here. And I'm going to use a post-it note. Look, my post-it notes are stamping up one so it matches. And I need my Memento ink pad. I'm going to stamp onto the post-it note. So you've been looking in the catalogue, Tracy. It'll be a new bedtime reading. I might do two of those, just in case. From Australia, what time is it with you, Rhonda? Must be, very early morning, surely. Out, so these are like masks, and then I can keep these in my stamping case. So you want to cut quite close to the if connection's bad tonight for people, it could be due to weather. You know, weather is it can affect connection when the weather's bad. Just cutting right on the line here. It is a little bit arduous. This is a little bit of an intricate stamp, but it's worth it. It'll hopefully be worth it. I've sort of planned what I'm doing, but not really quite. Let's see how it goes, eh? I have made something earlier to show you and share. So, I did get a little bit organised this afternoon. So, I hope we're all okay. Right, so, like the card I did on Coffee and Card, I'm going to stamp up the spine of this card now. I'm going to start in the middle because it's easier to work out if it's 4:30 a.m. Wow. So I'm going to stamp in the middle. Oh, thank you, Craig. That was one of Lynn's favourites. Is Lynn, are you on tonight? I'm going to stamp like that. Oh, look at that. And then what I'm going to do I can't believe I've done that right. Okay. Wash my hands. What we'll do is rid of that and we'll use it for something else and we'll come back, don't worry, I've got another one. I can't even see where the black ink is anyway, never mind. No sweat. See, it happens to me as well. Okay. I'm going to put the lid on my ink pad for now. Oh, Geraldine, you love all bloody. Oh, well, there you go, love. You've not heard it for ages, huh? Who's singing in the head too? Yeah, yeah. Is it on my cuff? I don't know. You see, don't think so, Maria, but thank you. I've gone a bit smarter tonight because after this, I've got, I think one of it. We've got a Stampin' Up Leaders Summit, which is a, it, should have been in New Orleans, like for Stamping Up Leaders. I wasn't going to go, but it's online now because of COVID. Thank you, Craig. And and it's now online. So it starts tonight, and you can see each other on screen. So I thought, oh, so I've got to be up till 11 tonight on this Leaders Summit. I'm going to do another one. I should have maybe fit one in there, but anyway, never mind. So basically what happens is your mask sort of covers up and you don't have a gap, but I've got a gap there, but that's fine, because what I'm going to do, I might do a little leaf. Reminds you of school, Kathy. What I'm going to do there is a little leaf poking out. Look, two little leaves there. A little bit of colouring now with the blends, because I know some of you have them, some of you don't. So let's look at comments. Reminds you of Sunday school and primary school. Oh, you had, oh, you have this at your first wedding. Oh, well, I don't know, that was on the Craig's list tonight. So, oh, bit of ABBA now. Right, so I've never coloured these in with blends before. I'm going to use Highland Heather, and I'm going to open that up because I find that if I make it flat it's easier, because if not it's popping up all the time, yeah? So actually I might start on the leaves because they're probably easier to show you. So I'm just going to go down the veins with the darker ones. Is Gary singing along to this one, Sally? Yep, I'm just going to go down the veins. Like that. Oh, missed one. Lisa, you love this. Yeah, Lisa, these are different, and I'll try and explain. Because it's a minefield. These are alcohol pens, okay? So those markers that you've got are water-based ink. They're like a similar ink to what's in the ink pads, so you can colour on the stamps like you did in that class. These have got alcohol in, so you should never colour on your stamps with these. The reason why they've got alcohol in is to make them blend, so you can do like shading. So that's why you have a dark and a... I think that one's running out. You have a dark and a light one. I'll zoom in a bit and show. So I'm going to direct you, Lisa, to some of my top tips videos. In fact, if you go on YouTube, your piece of homework, if you go on my YouTube channel, if you go back to the channel, and when you've got an hour to spend, and go on my playlists, there's a top tips videos, and it's perfect for people like yourself. And it's one of some of the videos are about all the ink pads. Are you singing a duet, Sally? So what I'm gonna do now is take the dark. This is gonna probably take me nearly all the evening to do this colouring. I'm just going to apply like a little bit of the dark on the leaves, And what you sort of should do is, because I've followed a few, if you look at the petals, do dark where a petal overlaps another petal. So it's almost like shadow. I mean, I don't go, is this the right colour? No, this is the wrong colour I've picked up. Oh well, never mind. I thought this was dark Highland Heather, but it's not. It's light Blackberry Bliss, but I've done it now, so we'll see what it looks like, and I'll root in a tub and get another one out. I'm not stressing today. Trying not to be stressy this week. Love that one, Craig. Lots of love for that one. Nice bit of ABBA. So then what I'm going to do is go over and blend the dark with the light, even though it's a different colour. Hopefully it should still come out nice. I thought I was really organised tonight and got everything ready. And it's gone a bit wrong, but never mind. That's life. Oh, I love this song. So I'm trying to blend the darker colour into the lighter colour, but maybe it won't work brilliantly because they're two completely different colours, but never mind, let's have a go. Hope you had a nice day out yesterday, Lorraine. Oh, thanks, Maria, with tips videos. Yeah, I know you watched a lot of them. I've done about 10 videos, Lisa. But some of them are literally 5 minutes long. Some of them are more like 15 minutes. Is Gary singing to this one, Sally? This pen. So what I'm trying to do is blend the darker colour into the lighter colour. It's not come out too badly, actually, to say. I'm probably going to do a little bit of dark in here and blend around that. Does one colour have to be dry? No, I don't really wait, Marlene. I just crack on, really. I think it's best just to don't leave it too long. Honestly, I don't know all the answers. I just do it and just... If it doesn't look right, I try again another way. I'm not... I'm a bit of a trial and error kind of person. I'm just going to go over all this now. And what I'm going to do now is use the right pen. Just look in my pen tub. Right, I found the dark one now. You had a fabulous day. You don't think Gary knows this one, I swear. I don't know who it is. I think he's Boys to Men or something like that. Something like one of those boy bands. And I swear. Who did that one, Craig, please?
All for One.
All for One. Boys to Men. Three words, nearly right. We love that one. You like doing that at weddings, don't you? And I swear. So I'm just sort of going around the edges of some of the petals. And sometimes Stampin' Up! Help us with this, with the actual stamps, because they do a little bit of shading on the stamps. I don't even actually know which leaf belongs to, which petal belongs to which flower now. Let's see if this blends a bit nicer. Yeah, look, it's blending more.
see the difference in a minute. I'll lift up the project and show you. So Vanessa, I will get to using the peony die for you before the end of the video, because I've practiced with it. I think it might be Jennifer Rush, Lorraine, I'm not sure. Yeah. So actually you can see how this has blended a lot better than the other one. I shall have to make. Now what you might have to do, if you make a one layer card like this and you do colouring, it does soak through, does the colour. I'm going to show you that in a second. So we have to have a little contingency, because it looks like you've sort of made a mistake. The music's making you emotional tonight. Oh, Kathy. Oh, sending you a virtual squeeze. So can you see the difference between the top one? It's a different tone. I've got it wrong. But you can see how it blends a lot better with the two that are supposed to be blended together. Ah, you've got a recording of Celine singing it. Ah, very good. Okay, so this is what I mean by how you'll see it coming through the other side. So what we'll do is we can stick a piece of white. In fact, we could cut this bit down that I did wrong and stick that in there. So I'll just carry on doing the other two. I'm a bit cross about that one that I got wrong, because I wonder if I go over. I've just got to leave it now, and I'll probably do another version of it. Yeah, hopefully you can see the... Wait till you see what I'm going to do in a sec, Sally. Craig, you're making Kathy very emotional this evening.
Good.
He says, good, Kathy.
All about healing and being loved.
Oh, he says it's all about healing and being loved. There we go. I am doing this fairly quickly for the purposes. It's quite dark tonight. I'm sorry, we've had to put big light on, as Peter Kay would say. Got big light on. So I know that it, probably on the screen it's not. Might have to look at getting some kind of extra lighting or something. You quite like the effect, Sheila. Hi Sheila, I'm not sure I've seen your name before. Where are you from, if you don't mind me asking? Yeah, I know what you mean. Every flower in the garden looks different. Mm-hmm. Now this one just was my extra one, so I'm just literally scribbling a bit of dark Oh, you had your first smooch to it. Oh. I think music always takes you back to memories and times. That's it with the card shut. There we go. And what I'm going to do now is take a light pool party. You're in leaking staffs. You're normally a lurker, but you've come in tonight. Well, that's lovely, Sheila. Thank you. So what I'm going to do is... Lots of people emotional tonight, Craig. It must be the weather as well. So I'm going round with this blue, just around the edge of... So you need to... And what you'll find, Sally, is this really makes it pop. So I'm going round the edge of everything. Zoom in for you. Can you see there how it makes it pop a bit? But it's a little bit stark. So what I'm going to do, I can assure you the light's better in person. We have a pen called a colour lifter, and it's sort of going to take a bit of the colour away. So I'm just going to like go over with the colour lifter and scribble in circles on the edge of the pool party that I've just done. And what it's going to do is it's just going to fade it a bit, blend it out. I will put a picture of this on my Facebook page tomorrow, because if I do one tonight, it's not going to be good light. I haven't forgotten about meeting you tomorrow, Rebecca. I just need to message Kylie. I don't know what the weather's supposed to be like tomorrow. I've not looked. How's your Body Shop stuff, Sally? Zoom in again and hopefully you can see the effect of that there. Yeah, you can see it's now sort of a bit more faded and it makes it pop a little bit. So I'll zoom back. What I'm going to do is, now if I do this wrong, I've got a contingency. I'm going to do this as a one layer, so I don't want to... I love that one, Craig. I think that's becoming one of my new faves. So this says, my thoughts are with you. Oh, I've done that quite straight. Okay. Now, one thing I did want to show you, I think it's worked. Yeah, okay. Can you, the little gems that you got in the parcel in the post? You can actually colour things like this with the blends. I'm just reading, your picture's very blurred. My laptop does keep going, but it's not blurred on my phone, which is recording. I think it's the weather, Lorraine. I think the weather's having a problem with a few bits. So what you can do is you can colour these with your blends. Now, you might want to go a tone darker for it to take effect. So can you see that one? That one is with the wrong colour, but it's gone a bit darker. So I'm just colouring over these with my blends. I think it could be weather here, Lorraine, and internet connections and things, because mine keeps going a bit blurred. Oh, I'm glad your stuff's nice, Sally. Oh, I just said, Rebecca, that I haven't forgotten. I just need to chase Kylie. So I've just colouring a couple of these in. What I thought I would do is maybe pop. That one, Craig, please.
And I love you so.
Oh, and I love you so. Oh, yeah. I don't know where to put this one. I love this song. I think Craig's been practicing these while I was at Aldi today. Because this is one of my faves. I've just added three little gems and I've coloured them in lilac to match. So it's like they match. Nice little trick for you. Oh, what we were going to do is sort that out, weren't we? So just do it like a millimetre smaller than your card, or maybe 2 millimetres. Side to cover that over. And no one ever need know that we've coloured that wrong and that I've stuck that over there. So there is, it is a simple card. It took me quite a bit of time to do the colouring, but I hope you like the masking technique. You don't need a lot of pens colours, so I've literally used one, two, and then you would need the pool party one, even though we're only using the light. They come in a combo set, and then the colour lifter comes on its own. So it's three sets and the colour lifter. But they, an old olive blends is the one I got first because I use it so much for leaves. Your vitamin E cream is fabulous. Ah, bless you. Right, so that's that card. Let me have a look at the time. Right, so I did want to make two cards and share the peonies, but Angela's got the peonies, so, and Vanessa's interested in them, so I may as well go onto this and see how far we get. This is one of the peonies that I've put together, okay, and it comes in the peony die set, which I'm which you get a lot of dies. So you get this die, which actually cuts out, where have I put the stamp set now? This die cuts this one out, yeah. Then you get this die that cuts out the one I've just used, another die to cut out this one, and then you get ones for the leaves. Okay, you get a lovely scallop edge die, and you get leaf dies and a stamen die. But you also get I'm just gonna thank you, Craig, from me, because that is one of my faves.
Okay.
You know. Well, I did tell you on first day we met, but right, so you also get four dies to make these peonies. Okay, and they look a bit strange when you get them. And you think, what the heck am I going to do with these? Okay, they look like they're not going to do anything. Okay, so I've already prepped. So I did seem a bit unorganised today. However, I have got a little bag of stuff that I've prepped. I've got some leaves that I've cut out, a stamen, and I've got the four shapes in size order. Okay, so just need to make sure I've got them the right way. Yeah. Now, I don't know if you can see from this. Well, you can. Hang on. Curled it up a little bit, and I did actually ink it, but I might need to ink it again, because I find to curl it up easier so it doesn't like bend and look like you've obviously folded it. It's easier to spray it with water. I know that might sound a little bit strange, but I'm going to show you what to use. So this is a really handy item to have that we sell, and what page number is it on? It's on the page with loads of the tools, and the one with the aqua painters on that are used on Sunflower Week. It's on page 146, and it's item number 13. They're down right down here, and they're called Stamping Spritzers, and you get two for £2.75. They're actually good to have in your handbag and spray yourself with water. But you can put like shimmer paint in them and make shimmer mists and things like that. But what I do is, when I'm making any punched out flowers, I sort of spray them, and it makes it a little bit more pliable. But what I am going to do first is I'm going to ink and sponge the edges. I've got my Highland Heather ink pad, and I've got my dauber, and I'm going to ink the edges. Now, I've put a lot on there, but I think once I spray it, it'll dilute it down. So I have sponged that quite heavily. And then next one. Are you watching, Vanessa? Gorgeous, Craig. Gorgeous songs tonight, love. I love this one too. Oh, all my faves. Right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to spray them a little bit. I know so many techniques, Lisa. So what I'm going to do, I mean, this is water. I'm just going to spray the edges that I'm going to curl. You maybe should have some kitchen roll when you do this. Now, it is going to run because I'm wetting it. That's why I did it quite heavily. Look, the ink is running, but it's fine. I love this song. Okay, so I've done this, as I said, to make it more pliable. And what you can do is curl it now, scrunch it a bit, yeah? Because it's wet, it just scrunches nicer. Oops. I've not seen anyone demoing this with the water and scrunching it. But I just find it just, you can manipulate it, I suppose, a little bit more, yeah? Yep, I spritzed the rolled flowers, Tracy, yep. So, what happens is they all go into each other. So the small one tucks into the large one like that. Just make sure it doesn't hook on. And what you can do is at the back, they match up perfectly. I don't know if you can see that there. Yep. So you've then got the start of the flower. So what I'm going to do is, from the back, I'm just going to lift it up, put a little bit of glue just to hold it in place. I love that one. I love that, Everlasting Love. Craig, you're on fire tonight. It tunes. I feel like it's a personal concert of my faves. So then that one, those two, we're going to put into that slot there, and we're going to match it up at the bottom. Hope you're following this, Vanessa. And it, again, look, it absolutely perfectly matches up. I'm going to glue that just to hold it a bit too much there, just to hold it down a bit. And again, what you can do is you can be manipulating it still while it's gluing, because it's still wet. Yep. And then this one that's drenched, this then slots in there. And I've not actually thought of a project for this, so. Oops. You just need to put a bit of glue, a small bit on this one, because it's only got a tiny piece at the bottom. That's matched up. Okay, so my workstation's a bit wet now. I'll move it over here a bit, it's drier. So what we can do now is pull these back a bit, just make it a bit more 3D, yeah? And if you want to, when it's dry, you can still apply your sponging. And then there's like a little bit that sticks down here. And that's where there's like a little gap. It's like a little V-shape. And the stamen that you cut out sticks down there. Like that. I've not glued that, but I think it'll be fine for now. Okay, so I'm going to probably sponge that a bit more. It would look nice on a present, wouldn't it? Craig, this is gorgeous. Bit of Stevie. Oh, man. I'm going to try an ink, but even though it's wet. See what it looks like tomorrow. There we go. It will look nice in a present, Geraldine. You give me an idea. You've given me an idea, and I'm going to execute it when I can remember. Oh, I know where it is, so I'm just going to reach over. Your grandma used to sing it, Kathy. Oh, gosh, you will be having an emotional night then. Remember this card I made the other week with this set? I've still got it here in the box. Let's use this as a gift box so I don't have to get another one out. Yeah, and we could maybe put our peonies on. What do we think? Maybe just one, actually. We don't want to be too generous. Oh. Right, so I've put the box on the wet bit. Right. What I'm going to do is measure this. It's 14 by 9.5. So, where did I put my coloured card? Cutting this about the width of the box, and then I'm going to cut some paper. Just doing this off the cuff here now. Okay. Oh, Craig, that was lovely again. Beautiful. Loving it. So Kathy's nan used to sing it to her granddad, or granddad used to sing it to her nan. Kay's husband, that was the first record that he ever bought her for her 18th. I must know all these things. I'm just gonna do a little strip, see what it looks like. Yes, we'll do that. I think I might need a new glue. Yeah, I'm going to put a bit of ribbon on it. Don't you worry. I love my ribbon. I'm going to show you a trick with it as well. And I'm going to pop that across there, across the middle. I think my glue's well up. Oh, no, there's still a bit left. What time are we on? Oh, 20 past. I'll probably just get to finish this one tonight. Right, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to leave that because I'm going to put some ribbon around it. But, my ribbon is blue. Oh, very pale pool party. And I don't want that. I want my ribbon to be purple. So guess what? I'm going to colour my ribbon with the blends. So, I'm going to use the dark. And I'm just going to... Is it the dark? Yep. I'm just going to sweep it across... ribbon, because it's a very sheer ribbon, it soaks in. Another one, I love that one as well. Who did that one, Craig, please?
Extreme.
Oh, I would have never guessed that, but I knew it. Knew the song. Good tunes tonight, love. I think my pen's running out. don't know if I've got another one. I have to get it on my shopping list. I might just have enough to do it. Yeah, so because it's sheer, it just soaks the ink in and it goes all even. Does sort of alter the texture of the ribbon a bit, but not much. Don't think I've quite got enough yet. We're going to do this technique on my gnomes class. The end of September, so we shall be doing this on that class. The light's bad, so I can't really see if I've coloured it all, but never mind. So let's have a go and see if I've coloured enough. Away with it. No. I think I need to colour a bit more. Probably advise you to do this colouring when it's a better light situation. Because the light's terrible tonight. That was gorgeous. So. You can see it's purple. I probably need to colour. What was that one, Craig, please?
To Love You More.
Oh, wow. Very lovely, lovely tonight. Loving it. So what I'm going to do is just put that underneath. Just to... Yeah, that'll be enough now. So I can actually stick that on. Don't know what's to go in the box, but yeah, well, we don't. I know, Lisa, but we don't have a reel in this colour. I'm really running out of glue now. That'll do. It's not all types of ribbon that work, but a sheer one you can really get away with without too much effort. So. Now I cut a few leaves out earlier. And they've got like matching little, I'll just move the box. They've got like these little accents. Like that go like that to make them a bit more 3D. So I need to probably get my fine tip glue for this. I might try a Tombow. I'll try my fine tip first. I know, but I can't cheat, Amarie, because I'm demoing. yeah, you could cheat. Oops, it's not behaving for me tonight, that. Oh, hi, Donna. Yeah, the white seam binding, yeah. Oh, yeah. I tested it out the other week, and it's such a light colour that it took it. I don't think that's that one. Ah. They've got different shapes, and I picked the wrong one up. You love Mary Poppins, oh good. I know he's got a right medley for you tonight. I think I might try my Tombow. I am a Tombow girl. This one's probably full, oh no, empty I mean. I think I might stick this down when it's better light tomorrow. Oh, I'm off the screen, sorry. Yeah, oh no, Tombow is this one. This is what I normally use, but I just call it Tombow. It's in the catalogue, it's called multi-purpose glue. That's what I use for everything. I didn't realise I were off screen then, sorry guys. I'm struggling with the light to get this needle back in the fine tip. It's hard enough when it's good light. How many people are singing along? Is Gary singing along, Sally? Right, I think I've left that out too long and stuck it up. Never mind. Right, so I think what I'm going to do is just, I don't feel happy with those leaves positioning and stuff. I'm going to die cut a circle. Woo! I'm going to sort of finish off in a sec. Die cut a circle tomorrow and stamp a little sentiment there. And have that underneath the bow. And I will show you those on my social media pages. So where have I put the card? So we've got a card and we've got a little box tonight. Oh, is it your favourite all-time film? Oh, brilliant. He's in the other room watching Spark. Yeah, yeah, that's okay. It's Mandy on. This is her favourite. So I will finish those off. Although, finish the card off. I'm really pleased with the card, apart from the little colouring error. I'll finish these off and put pictures on my Facebook of them when I'm happy with the positioning. So I don't know what I've got to tell you. Oh, yeah, I do actually. So let me just go grab something to show you. Hang on. So September Parcel in the Post is now available for booking, reserving, and Evan and I started putting them together yesterday. So September's going to be the Snowflake Splendor, and it's a lot of the colours. Some of the colours I've been using tonight. You're going to get the ribbon, the pool party that I've coloured actually. Some of the gems, half a bag of the papers, cut down to 6x12. Some of the gorgeous balmy blue glimmer. And then you get two sheets of each of the coloured coordinating card. So it's Highland Heather, Pool Party, Coastal Cabana, Balmy Blue, Pacific Point, Misty Moonlight and Night of Navy. You'll also get two thick Whisper White and two standard Whisper White sheets. I'll show the papers, yeah. And if you're collecting, then you get a sheet of the coloured extra. Yeah, I'll show the papers, Maria. These designs have been hand-painted by the artists at Stampin' Up. So this is the reason why they've got like a watercolour wash effect or an ice wash, because they've been hand-painted with watercolours. Okay, so this is half a sheet. So that's one side, and then the other side. That one's my favourite one, the one on top. And then you've got, you can see that ice wash there. And then you've got the snowflakes there. So this one's not as washy. It's a bit more solid colours. Then you've got a wash back one there. More snowflakes. Oh, I think we've shown that one. That's another. Yeah, these are just other sides of the ones I've shown. Yeah, so that was the first one. And then this is a lovely one. This is the one I've used for a lot of the gnomes. It's like a watercolour. Icicles. More icicles, snowflakes. So it's got lots of blues and lilac and a lilac in it. The great thing about doing the parcel in the post is it builds up your card stock, because I've now done 4 months and I worked out that people have got would have 19 different colours of card now. So which is a really cost-effective way of building your card up. You know, I appreciate that you probably don't need to have a full pack of card that's £8 to make a card. So that's why I'm doing the parcel in the posts. So it breaks it down. I've already worked out October's, which is going to be autumnal. So yeah, that's the parcel in the post. Still got places left for Sunflower class on 8th of September, but I do need to close that off very soon. And the Gnomes class, it's the Peace and Joy class next Saturday, 5th. Booking's really closed for that now. Probably if I put an order in tomorrow, it could get here in time. Likewise, I'm closing off bookings for the Sunflower on the 8th tomorrow. And then I've got the Gnomes on the 26th. So, and I'm just working out what the coffee and card is going to be. So, I'm just going to turn the camera around. Craig's playing our favourite song. I'm just going to just turn around. Hang on, look how dark it is now. Oops. There we go. Oh, there's my hand. There's Mr. Maestro. Just have a little drink. I've hardly had a drink tonight. Your mum wants inks now. Oh, that's good, Cafe. Let's get her some inks sorted out. So, Craig's just finishing off. So I'll get him to come and say bye. So I'm getting all these messages about this event that's starting in 25 minutes that I'm going to be on. So thank you for joining us tonight. Thanks for some great feedback tonight, Craigie. You all
love songs tonight, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Really lovey.
Nice relaxing song tonight.
Yeah. So thank you for joining us. We'll look at your comments and Diet Coke again, yes.
Yeah.
Of course. Well, thanks, Tracy. Tracy's first time viewer. And we'll see you next week.
See you next
week. It's getting dark now, so yeah. I'll have to get a new light. So thanks for tuning in. See you next week.